special message for the month of August 2009. Courtesy of the Ancient Word series. Homosexuality is a mystery of God. This is a special message to all of my dear brothers and sisters who are homosexual. Thy Creator wants you to know that you are loved. That which you are is by His ordination. It is not a precept that is explainable by the intellectual, religious and philosophical dictates and ideologies of mankind. Though there are references in ancient scripture that it is an abomination and sin it is, and is allowed by the Creator so, then what is homosexuality? Only the Creator has the answer, and all of you who are homosexual will, like everyone else, stand before the judgment bar of God, and accountability will come from the heavenly tablets. Forget not that thy heavenly Father Yahweh is all-seeing and all-knowing, and He sees and knows that many of you are hurting. He wants you to know that you are His children like everyone else, and that He loves you very, very much. Each and every one of you were created intelligent, bright, charismatic and colorful like the holy rainbow, which is special to our Creator. You are no different than thy heterosexual brothers and sisters, for there is only one humanity upon the earth, and you are all one with me, for I am one. Strive always to walk in the way of my anointed one, Yeshu the Christ and High Priest in the kingdom of Yahweh. Walk honestly before thy heavenly Father, and you will be blessed with His love, His wisdom and the peace of Christ Yeshu. Thus saith Christ Yeshu in the Gospel of the Holy 12. Verily I say unto you, in the beginning, all creatures of God did find their sustenance in the herbs and the fruits of the earth alone, till the ignorance and the selfishness of man turned many of them from the use which God had given them to, that which was contrary to their original use. But even these shall, yes, return to their natural food, as it is written in the prophets, and their words shall not fail. Verily God ever giveth of the eternal life and substance, to renew the forms of the universe. It is therefore of the flesh and blood, even the substance and life of the eternal, that ye are partakers unto life, and my words are spirit and they are life. And if ye keep my commandments, and live the life of the righteous, happy shall ye be in this life, and in that which is to come. Marvel not therefore, that I said unto you, except ye eat of the flesh and drink the blood of God, ye have no life in you. And the disciples answered, saying, Lord, evermore give us to eat of this bread, and to drink of this cup, for thy words are meat and drink indeed. By thy life, and by thy substance, may we live forever. To the gospel of peace, Christ Yeshu said, because all manner of evil and all manner of abominations have their dwelling in your body and your spirit. If you will that the living God, the eternal Almighty One's word and His power may enter you, defile not your body and your spirit, for the body is the temple of the Spirit, and the Spirit is the temple of God, the eternal Almighty One. Purify, therefore, the temple, that the Lord of the temple may dwell therein, and occupy a place that is worthy of Him. For the heavenly Father, Yahweh's love gives to all life everlasting in the kingdom of God, the eternal Almighty One. For love is eternal. Love is stronger than death. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am become a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. Though I tell what is to come, and know all secrets, and all wisdom, and though I have faith strong as the storm which lifts mountains from their seat, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and give all my fire that I have received from my Father, but have not love, I am in no wise profited. Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious, works not evil, knows not pride, is not rude, neither selfish, is slow to anger, imagines no mischief, rejoices not in injustice, but delights in justice. Love defends all, love believes all, love hopes all, love bears all, never exhausts itself, but as for tongues they shall cease, and, as for knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we have truth in part, and error in part, but when the fullness of perfection is come, the which is in part shall be blotted out. When a man was a child he spoke as a child, understood as a child, thought as a child, but when he became a man he put away childish things. For now we see through a glass, and through dark sayings. Now we know in part, but when we are come before the face of God, the Eternal Almighty One, we shall not know in part, but even as we are taught by Him. And now remain these three: faith, hope and love, but the greatest of these is love. Look upon the rainbow, and praise Him, that made and bent it. We love you, and let us all be ye heterosexual or homosexual walk in peace and in love. Be not judgmental of one another, be not afraid to love thy neighbor, care for the creatures of the earth, obey the 12 commandments of the Spirit given by Christ Yeshu, in the brightness of the beautiful colors of the rainbow hurt not yourselves, hold your heads up high, walk forward dear sons and daughters of light, and in your uniqueness, share your positivity with the world. And abase not love, for God is love. Blessings to you, your families and the creatures within your care, Reverend Melissa Smith. If you will, please consider making a donation to the Ancient Word series today. It would be a much needed blessing to me, and the creatures within my care. We love you, and want to hear from you. In wisdom, peace and love, peace be with thee.